First person shooter mode. We turning your song to a funeral. To them niggas that say they gon' office, you better be talking about working in cubicles. Yeah, them boys had a lot, but I knew.
Saying they gon' office, you better be working in cubicles. Like it's Michael Scott in The Office versus OFF space US. Ridiculous wordplay within the first couple bars by Cole. But what I love is like a kid running around playing like laser guns, going pew pew pew. Get it, first person shooter. J. Cole on the ad-libs is money right now.
Niggas just say they want office, you better be talking about working in cubicles. Yeah, them boys had a lot, but I knew the code. A lot of niggas debating my numero, not the 3-9.
Even what sounds like just like a simple throwaway line. Thought they had it locked, but I knew the code. You know, breaking the lock, knowing the code of conduct and how things should be. Like, smooth lines like that are so underrated by Cole because he just packs in doubles on doubles on doubles on doubles. Tell me who is better than Cole on features.
With Cole, yeah, them boys had a lot, but I knew the code. A lot of niggas debating my numero. Not the 3, not the 2, I'm at UNO. Yeah. Numero UNO, me and Drizzy, this shit like the Super Bowl. Man, this shit done it bigger.
You better tell J. Cole what we owe him right now. UNO spells uno, Spanish for one, as we all know. But also UN, because a lot of times when you say and, you drop the D and you go and. So it sounds like an N. So UNO, the letter U and the letter O, UNO, which also spells out uno. What's he telling us right now? You better adjust these top GOAT lists right now. There's a number one in the building.
Numero UNO, me and Drizzy, this shit like the Super Bowl.
You know what's cool though is like this little cadence bend. Like no percussion is dropped in yet, nothing. J. Cole jumps in and he starts down here. Da 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 da. So it's a very like sort of lazy, laid back delivery. Drop down with a cadence, and then right here you hear his cadence change, and he's so good at this, like pulling you in, do 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 do, and then pushing it with more of his like aggressive, you know, more personality filled rap delivery. Listen right here to the transition.
Oh, a lot of niggas debating my numero, not the 3, not the 2, I'm at UNO.
Ready?
Yeah. Numero UNO, me and Drizzy, this shit like the Super Same. Bowl. Man, this shit done it big as the...
Big as the what?
Big as the Super Bowl.
Big as
the difference is, it's just two guys playing shit today.
Big as the Super Bowl. You know what the numero uno makes me think of? Nelly, remember when he got to play the Super Bowl? And he dropped I Am Number One, bragging about that. This is as big as the Super Bowl right now when you get two goats on the track.
Big as the Super Bowl, but the difference is it's just two guys playing shit that they did in the studio. Niggas usually send their verses back to me and they be terrible, just like a 2-year-old. I love a dinner with some
terrible, like a 2-year-old playing off of the terrible twos.
Niggas usually send their verses back to me and they be terrible, just like a 2-year-old. I love a dinner with some fine women when they start debating about who the GOAT. I'm like, go ahead, say it then. Who the GOAT? Who the GOAT? Who the GOAT? Who the GOAT? Who you bitches really rooting for? Like a kid that had bad from January to November, nigga, it's just you and Cole. Big as the what? Big as the what?
That was smooth. That was smooth. Kid who acts bad from January to November. Guess what he's going to get in his stocking for Christmas? He's going to get Cole playing off of J. Cole versus receiving Cole because he's being bad and Santa's going to put him on his naughty list.
Nigga, it's just you and Cole.
Drake coming through with the gifted raps right now.
Big as the what? Super Bowl. Niggas so thirsty to put me in beef. I set in my words and start looking too deep. I look at the tweets and start sucking my teeth. I'm letting it rock because I love the mystique. I still want to give me a song where I be. Can't trust everything that you saw on IG. Just know if I diss you, I make sure.
I still want to get on a song with YB. So there he is. He's addressing the young boy. Very interesting. So he dropped the Yachty Secret Recipe feature. And this is coming late. This has been like a fourth quarter substitution to get this on Drake's album. Let's go.
Didn't want to give me a song where I be. Can't trust everything that you saw on IG.
I like that line, though, that he lets it rot. Like, he doesn't respond right away. He doesn't have a knee-jerk reaction. He kind of lets things sink down or decay or just let the buzz stir because it just creates more of a mystique. And it gets people talking. It's so true. Like, it allowed me to talk about it, for us to speculate on it, and to dive into the situation, to look at it. Is he talking about YB in that situation? Is he not? But see, J. Cole, so many times throughout his career, when he could go into the beef, like he could lean into it. It's like, yeah, I'm getting a lot of attention for it. Like, beef is polarizing. Beef gets you clicks. Like, yeah, I could get into a diss war. And he's more than capable of it with his pen. So many times, instead of destructing and tearing apart, He chooses to offer flowers. He chooses to extend an olive branch. And right here, he's extending an olive branch to YB, right? I still want to get on a track with you, man. Right, cause I love the mystique. And that just speaks levels to kind of his philosophy, who he is as a human being, just the way that he has always moved. So humble within this game. And yet, such a killer when he gets on a microphone. Wanna give me a song where I be? Can't trust everything that you saw on IG. Just know if I diss you, I make sure you know that I hit you like I'm on your caller ID. I'm aiming the album to fall off. It's pretty ironic cause it ain't no fall off. Hit you like your caller ID. You know who it is when Cole's coming through. Cole World. Like I'm on your caller ID. I'm naming the album to fall off. It's pretty ironic cause it ain't no fall off for me. Still in this bitch getting bigger. They waiting on the kid to come drop. Naming an album, The Fall Off. As rumor and speculation goes, didn't J. Cole, it's funny because he's got the IG lines, but I think he teased it on IG, didn't he? When he like laid out his plan, right? And we were going to get the off season. And then we're going to get another album before The Fall Off, right? Or is The Fall Off next? I don't think so, but it's like leading into The Fall Off. And people are saying that's supposed to be his final album, like his culmination album. Like he started off and now he's falling off. So he's playing off of that because he wants to go out at his prime, at his heights. Ironic, he's naming it The Fall Off. Pretty ironic, cause it ain't no fall off for me. Still in this bitch getting bigger, they waiting on the kid to come drop like a father to be. Love when they argue the hardest MC. Is it K-Dot, is it Aubrey or me? We the big three like we started a league. But right now I feel like Muhammad Ali. The big three like we started a league. Shout out to Ice Cube in the big three basketball league when it's 3-on-3. I mean, that's been going for a few years now. Come on. The big three, K-Dot, Kendrick Lamar, Aubrey, none other than Drake, and J. Cole. Is it Aubrey or me? That's it. There's no more debate on lists. J. Cole is giving us the list right now. Like a father to be. Love when they... Waiting for the kid to drop like a father to be was a dope bar too. They're waiting on the kid, waiting on J. Cole to drop versus the kid dropping out. I'm ready to be a father now. He's sonning all of them in this game. Is it K-Dot? Is it Aubrey or me? We the big three like we started a league. But right now I feel like Muhammad Ali. Yeah, Muhammad Ali, the one that they call when they shit ain't connecting no more. Feel like I got a job in IT. Rhyming with me is the biggest mistake. The Spider-Man meme is me. Punchline on punchline on punchline. They're not connecting with their audience anymore. They're not making hits, so they gotta call J. Cole. Just like we're having troubles with internet issues, call up IT right now. Cole in the building. Feel like I got a job in IT. Rhyming with me is the biggest mistake. The Spider-Man. I talked about this on 8 a.m. in Charlotte, but I love this choice of beat selection by Drake, where we get like a vocal sample in the back of the mix, right? And I always enjoy when you can take that vocal sound and you cake it into the instrumentation. So it becomes a part of the beat. And I've always talked about this in the past, like vocal sounds are so different than regular instruments because everyone's vocal tone is unique to them. So therefore, every time you use a vocal sound on the beat, you get a new just sonicscape and a new type of production you couldn't get by playing a traditional instrument. So I always love cooking vocal samples into the instrumentation. Kanye is a wizard and a genius at that, but man, shout out to Drake using this again. Connecting no more, feel like I got a job in IT. Rhyming with me is the biggest mistake. The Spider-Man meme is me looking at Drake. It's like we recruited your homies to be demon deacons. We got them attending your wake. Hey, how the gang got away from the bars, man, and shit. Wake Forest Demon Deacon bars make sense. Cole shouting out North Carolina. Demon Deacons. Attending their funeral, Wake versus Wake Forest, mascot of the Demon Deacons. He's turning them into Demon Deacons, sending them straight down. He's spitting that fire like hell right now. Mistake, the Spider-Man meme is me looking at. And then the Spider-Man meme is that infamous meme where Spider-Man is looking at himself, pointing at himself. So it's like, you and me. Hey, Goat, how you doing? Eating some grass today? Me too. Drake, it's like we recruited your homies to be demon deacons. We got them attending your wake. Hey, how the gang got away from the bars, man, and shit like a prison escape. Everybody step as we're fucking and everybody breakfast and I'm about to clear up my plate. Everybody stepping, everybody breakfast, but also if you split apart breakfast, they break fast, like a fast break. Meanwhile, he's playing off of breakfast because he's just clearing his plate off right now. But the line before it, come on. Attending your wake. Hey, how the gang got away from the bars, man, and shit like a prison escape. What in the Michael prison escape is happening here? Right, rappers, we refer to our lines as bars. So the game got away from the bars. It stopped being about the pen. Stop being about the lyricism. So many people are like, oh, I just want to like dance to it. I want to vibe to it. It's all a vibe now. It's not about what you're saying and the talent that goes into the technicals. This is why we have channels like this that break down greats with the pen like J. Cole. Right, J. Cole, bringing back the bars. Tending your weight. Hey, how the gang got away from the bars, man, and shit like a prison escape. Everybody step as we're fucking and everybody breakfast and I'm about to clear up my plate.
When I show up, it's motion picture blockbuster. The goat with the golden pen, the top toucher, the spot rusher.
When I show up, it's motion picture, the blockbuster, the goat with the golden pen, the da 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 da. That flow switch right there. This is my favorite pocket he's found so far. He's punching like Muhammad Ali right now. Flow like a butterfly sting, cause J. Cole B.
The blockbuster, the goat with the golden pen, the top toucher. Woo. The spot rusher, spray this whole shit up, the crap duster. Not rusher, but apply pressure to your cranium. Cole's automatic when aiming him with the boy in the status of stadium.
Not Russia, but apply pressure to your cranium, to your dome, but also your could sound like you, Ukraine to Russia bars, and then spraying shit. He's spraying it on this beat right now like a crop duster, pesticide and everything, man.
Cranium, Cole's automatic with aiming him with the boy in the status of stadium.
J. Cole on features is just different. He's just different. Dogs barking. Hey.
I'm about to click out on this shit. I'm about to click.
Oh, I just had a moment. You know what? Honestly, I completely forgot that Drake was on this beat. I was just so lost in Cole world. Drake just surprised me. This is a beat switch right here.
I'm about to click out on this shit. I'm about to click. Whoa. I'm about to click out.
Drake tapping into some of the mainstream flows nowadays and the current trends in hip-hops with this flow switch right here. Going a little bit of like NBA Youngboy and Lil Durk style.
I'm down to click out on you hoes and make a crime scene. I click the trigger on a stick like a high beam, and I would Benny Will.
Trigger on the stick like a high beam, like you got the stick and you put the high beams on versus this. Come on.
I click the trigger on a stick like a high beam, and I would Benny Will Whip when I was 19. She called my number, leave her hanging. She got dry clean. She got an Android of messages.
Hanging the dry cleaners?
I'm green. Leave her hanging, she got dry clean. She got an Android of messages, it's lime green. I search one name and end up seeing 20 teens. Nadine, Christine, Justine, Kathleen, Charlene, Pauline, Claudine. Man, I pack them in this phone like some sardines. And they send me naked pictures, it's the small things. You niggas still taking pictures on a golf stream. My youngest richer than you rappers and they all stream.
Oh, that's a I'm way too successful type of flex. You still taking pictures on a golf stream, a private jet. We know Drake owns a Boeing 747. How you feel about that?
Taking pictures on a golf.
You know what? I don't know why. I'm going to shout out Nas. Like a Boeing 747. I don't give a flying fuck.
Stream. My youngest richer than you rappers and they all stream. I really hate that you've been selling them some false dreams. Man, if your pub was up for sale, I'd buy the whole thing. Would they ever give me flowers? Well, of course not.
If your pub was up for sale, what in the British tea bars is happening here?
Pub was up for sale, I bought a whole thing. Would they ever give me flowers? Well, of course not. They don't want to have that talk because it's a sore spot. They know the boy, the one they got a boycott. I told Jimmy Jam I use a Grammy as a doorstop. Girl, give me some hair because I need it. And if I fuck with you,
give me some head because I need it now.
Grammy as a doorstop, girl, give me
the line that I wanted to pause on, though, was using a Grammy as a doorstop. Man's got way too many Grammys right now.
Yeah, because I need it. And if I fuck with you, then after I might eat it. Niggas talking about when it's gonna be repeated. What the fuck, bro?
Wow, Drake's all in the pussy right now.
After I might eat it.
I might eat it. It's just the way that he says it.
Niggas talking about when it's gonna be repeated. What the fuck, bro? I'm one away from Michael. Nigga, beat it. Nigga, beat it. What? Beat it. What?
That's the best line on this. I was getting ready to say, man, like, I don't really like the switch up to this. Because for me, J. Cole just cooked the shit out of the track. So, like, we want 8 a.m. in Charlotte Drake, right? We need him to just take more of, like, that J. Cole style punchline, 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 doubles and triples. Not switching to, like, what's trending right now in this type of flow pocket. Because what this flow pocket does is it relies on, like, single syllable end rhymes. Da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da. Da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da, right? Whereas J. Cole's punching in with multi-syllable rhyme schemes throughout his whole verse. So for me, if you want to progress and keep up with what Cole's doing, you got to stay in sort of a similar range, not switch to this. But what I will say, though, is I do like this last line and how he comes out of here.
What the fuck, bro? I'm one away from Michael, nigga. Beat it, nigga. Beat it.
I mean, that's a new style of flex. Beat it. Michael Jackson, just beat it, versus he's telling you to beat it right now, or he's going to beat it in terms of Michael Jackson's record for most hit singles. He is one away. This is a hit single right here, isn't it? First person, yeah, First Person Shooter has dropped on Billboard. So if this tops the top 100, he's going to tie Michael with this one. And then, yeah, he's on route to beat it. That was a smooth triple right there. Get the tissues and the lotion. Back on none of favors, I don't need it. It puts the lotion in the basket. Wow. Honestly, yeah, I'm gonna say it. J. Cole has been killing features this year. Between this and the Lil Yachty feature, best features I've heard from an MC this year go to J. Cole. You tell me who's better and who's hotter with the pen right now. I will wait. Comment below. We can argue all day. J. Cole, Drake, you were Knoxville certified. Hope you guys like today's video. Listen for here at the end. Obviously, enjoying the content. Do me a huge favor. Support the channel directly. Subscribe, notifications on. Really, really does go a long way. Also, shout out to the Patreon, guys. More reactions, more content on there. A great way to support the channel directly. I'll put all links below. Anyway, stay safe, stay positive. It's Morley Knoxville. You know, I'll catch you again. In a house and I will wash the pots, I wipe the tops and spots, and wait and wait and wait, stop. Where you going with this waffle plot? You have to know what ass hag had a carpet washed. Oh dear, boo-hoo, what an awful job. But wait a minute, let me finish and we'll call the cops.
Call the cops?
No, the yobs.
What, she having a heart attack?
No, sit back, relax, I'll recall the facts. Please, retell my story, that is all I ask.
My
neighbor once had a tea kettle.
A what?
A tea kettle.
What the fuck?
A tea kettle.